This short video lecture introduces the water balance. Inflow, volume of water per unit of time, equals outflow, volume of water per unit of time, plus the change in water storage, delta S, of time, delta T. As an example of a water balance, let's take a look at the water balance of the Creepspach drainage basin or catchment in East Luxembourg, a catchment shown as a block diagram of the digital elevation model here. This is the catchment boundary. This is the outlet point, and the area of the catchment is 2.66 square kilometer. The water balance is basically the bookkeeping of the volume of water per unit of time that enters the system, inflow, leaves the system, outflow, and the change in water storage in the system in that same specified period of time. So when the inflow volume of water per unit of time is larger than the outflow volume of water per unit of time, then water is taken into storage over that same period of time, and the change in storage, delta S, delta T, is positive. When the outflow volume of water per unit of time is larger than the inflow volume of water per unit of time, then water is taken out of storage during that specified period of time, and delta S, delta T, is a negative number, smaller than zero. A hydrological year has a duration of 1 year and starts and ends at the end of the dry season, when water storage is at its lowest, or, alternatively, it starts and ends at the end of the wet season, when water storage is at its highest. If you were to look at a catchment for a hydrological year, then the storage at the beginning of the hydrological year is roughly the same as the storage at the end of the hydrological year, meaning that the same amount of water is stored in the catchment. The change in storage over the year, delta S, delta T, then is zero, and the water balance equation simply becomes inflow equals outflow. Now let's look more specifically at the Creepspach catchment. We assume that there is no leakage. The incoming term, inflow, is the precipitation P, and the outgoing terms are the discharge Q at the outlet point and evaporation EA from the catchment. Inflow equals outflow plus change in storage, delta S, over that period of time, delta T. There are some rules that you should always abide with. Always use a strictly defined area for the water balance, which in this example is the drainage basin or catchment. For instance, you cannot determine the amount of rainfall for a certain portion of the catchment and then determine the discharge from all of the catchment and insert these numbers in the water balance equation. Always use a strictly defined period of time. If you have established the amount of rainfall for a certain day, you must use the discharge and also the evaporation and also the change in storage over that same day. In essence, you always have to use volumes of water for the same strictly defined period of time. Thirdly, always use fixed units of measurement. For instance, you cannot insert precipitation in millimeter per day and discharge in cubic meter per day. So you must either rework rainfall from millimeter per day to cubic meter per day, or you must transform the discharge from cubic meter per day to millimeter per day. What links these values of millimeter per day and cubic meter per day? The catchment area in square meter. If you want to go from meter per day to cubic meter per day for the precipitation, multiply by the catchment area in square meter. And if you want to transform from cubic meter per day to meter per day for the discharge, divide by the catchment area in square meter. Of course, when you express discharge in millimeter per day or meter per day, this by no means is the velocity of the catchment stream, but meter per day is the volume of discharged water, cubic meter, per unit of time, day, and per catchment area, square meter.